the president, he took to Twitter, tweeting, quote, 3,000 people did not die in the two hurricanes that hit Puerto Rico.
There's a hurricane on the East Coast.
It's one thing us captains don't do is we don't run for the hills. We like to stay with our assets, you might as well say.
So why is President Trump talking so much about the one from last year? Because he says the media got a lot wrong. I'm Anders Hagstrom, and these are the facts. Death toll estimates in Puerto Rico have ranged from 6 to more than 8,000 in the year since Hurricane Maria devastated the territory. And blame has shifted just as much. Republicans blamed bad infrastructure, Democrats blamed Trump, and now Trump is blaming Democrats. And in doing so, Trump is getting blasted in the media for rejecting the official death toll.
That must be great relief to the Puerto Ricans who earlier this year put in front of their capital thousands of pairs of shoes bearing the names of those who had died as a result of the storm and its aftermath.
But where did that death toll come from? Let's go through the timeline. When Trump first visited Puerto Rico, he said he heard 6 to 18 people had died, but the first official estimate was 64 people. But both of those are a lot lower than the numbers we're hearing today. Those numbers jumped way up in June when Harvard released a study saying anywhere between 800 to 8,000 people had died. News outlets ran with the number in the middle at about 4,600, but Harvard's range was so massive that the study was basically useless. Then the Puerto Rico Department of Health released their own numbers. Finally, some numbers we can trust, right? Not quite. They estimated about 1,400 deaths, but then in late August, they changed it. George Washington University released their own study saying 3,000 people had died, and Puerto Rico looked through it and thought the numbers were more accurate than theirs, and adjusted the official estimate. But then President Donald Trump signed on to Twitter. He claims Democrats manufactured the 3,000 number to make him look bad, but while they did certainly do their best to make him look bad, they did not make up the number. The number comes from the total deaths in the months after Hurricane Maria, minus the total deaths over the same months in years without a hurricane. So it's safe to say that Trump probably shouldn't have brought this up.
Casualties don't make a person look bad. That's not So I have no reason to dispute these numbers.
Especially since those deaths aren't due to federal incompetence so much as bad infrastructure in Puerto Rico. And now let's go to some of your comments about our video about socialism. Fortunato Batres says, I wish actors, rappers, and singers would stay out of politics. I absolutely agree. Actors and singers are good at acting and singing, but they're not very good at making policy. Paula White says, don't trust an actor slash actress or singer. They all work under Satan's power. Not all of them, surely not all of them. Alan Bouchard says, if Mr. Kerry loves Canadian socialism so much, why is he living in the US? Because he makes a metric butt ton of money living in the US. That's probably why. Thanks for watching. Be sure to like us here at the DCNF Presents the Facts and our friends over at American Voices and the Daily Caller. Thanks for watching.